Good day, everybody. Gerdy Verwoerd here, Dirk Greatley guiding coach. On top of the Schafelkopf, is what I want to say. Let me see if that's correct. Yes, it is. On top of the Schafelkopf. And I'll, before I start on episode 17 of the series on how to hike, how to safely hike mountains and any other part of nature, I'll show you where I'm sitting. Hang on. I'll share the view that I have with you. There we go. Isn't that beautiful? Now, unfortunately, it is a bit foggy. Let me see, can I do the 360? Oh, there we go. And this is, let me see, what's on the other side? So, tip number 17 in episode 17 is bring your dog, or bring a dog. Perhaps you don't have one, but maybe you can borrow one from the neighbors or from friends. So, if you're going to go hiking by yourself and you don't really look forward to that by yourself part, anyone who has ever had a dog and hiked with a dog can tell you that hiking by yourself with a dog is not really hiking by yourself. It feels like you have company. It's not like he or she makes for great conversation. They don't. But it's just another living being that accompanies you. Now, it's important to realize that when you bring your dog, or when you intend to bring your dog, or a dog, that it's that dog needs to get used to hiking mountains just the same as you do. So you don't just take a dog into the mountains and start hiking serious hikes. You build it up just as you would for yourself. As you do that, keep an eye on his on their paws. So especially if you hike over rough terrain, so they can develop some they can thicken their skin. What do you call that? Can't remember now. Anyways, so that they can thicken their skin, or you can get them used to wearing shoes, wearing little boots. Doggy boots. So my dog never wore them because I trained my dog very slowly to hike up mountains. We've hiked, I think the hikes that I've done without my dog before he got too old to actually be hiking with me, I can count them on the fingers of two hands. He came everywhere with me and he became a pretty good climber too. Now, depending on where you hike, your dog may not be allowed to go off leash. So it is also good to be able to, for your dog to be able to go on a leash. And also, my dog had no eye for danger. He actually stepped off a cliff once. Luckily, a couple of meters below, there was a tree in which he got stuck, because otherwise I wouldn't have had a dog anymore. So my dog after that usually, well really always, was on a leash as when we went into the mountains, just because he would do the stupidest things when he was off leash. So if you don't want to hike by yourself, but you still want to go into the mountains by yourself or any other part of nature, bring a dog. When you have a dog that can go off leash, make sure that he doesn't go hunting when you're in the mountains, or that at least he is he comes back to you when you call him, because for example where I live, especially in the hunting season, there's hunters and farmers around here that shoot first and ask later if that happened to be your dog, and that's a bit of a bummer when you lose your dog that way. And all Also, it's not uncommon for dogs to get so excited in the mountains because they get so many new impressions and they smell so much. You know, and over here we have deer, we have chamois, we have mountain marmots, foxes, ibexes. So they smell so much, and once they get a smell up their nose, the blinders go on. They don't hear and they don't listen anymore, and they just go. And it's not uncommon for a dog to get lost in the mountains and to wander around the mountains for a couple of days and sometimes even longer. So train your dog to come back to you when you call him, and if that doesn't work, keep him on the leash is what I would do. Anyways, tip number 17, bring a dog. As always, go there greatly. Bye bye.